Bizzibox's expert information on carbon neutral. What is the carbon neutral company?
Carbon neutral company is a service provider, and we work with businesses primarily. And what defines our client base is we work with businesses who have committed to reducing their greenhouse gas emissions while growing profitable, sustainable businesses. And that's quite a challenge. And that translates into a service where we measure the footprint, we figure out ways of reducing it internally, and what unavoidable emissions remain between what a company is able to generate, reduce internally and its target, we make up with offset carbon reductions that are generated outside of their operations. So we purchase carbon credits, retire them in their name, and then they can either meet their target, or if they go to net zero immediately, they can claim carbon neutral status.
What is your definition of carbon neutrality?
Our definition of carbon neutrality is when a company has measured, reduced, and offset all of their emissions, greenhouse gas emissions, to net zero in any particular year.
What is the Kyoto Protocol?
The Kyoto Protocol is the United Nations framework. The United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change developed a regulatory framework whereby certain countries have accepted reduction targets for their greenhouse gas emissions, and other countries who have not accepted targets are still part of general efforts to reduce our global emissions. And so it is the first regulatory platform to force nations around the world to set and meet reduction targets. Now, at the moment, the Kyoto Protocol is considered to be somewhat flawed because it excludes the United States, which is not a signatory to the Kyoto Protocol, not yet, and it excludes some of the countries that are developing greenhouse gas emissions at the fastest rate, like China, India, Brazil, and Russia. So the concept of a regulatory minimum as delivered by the Kyoto Protocol is a very welcome step towards getting all nations to, you know, measure and reduce their emissions. But carbon offsetting and the voluntary carbon market goes way beyond that, because there's a belief that the combined efforts of regulation are not anywhere near delivery of what we need to do to stabilize our climate.
What is carbon offsetting?
Carbon offsetting is when you use a carbon reduction that somebody has generated that they wouldn't normally have generated because you've given them funds, and use that reduction to compensate for unavoidable emissions in your organization to reach a stretching greenhouse gas emission reduction target.
What is the difference between carbon offsetting and carbon reduction?
Your question is, what's the difference between an offset and a carbon reduction? A carbon reduction generates an offset when the project delivering that reduction sells that reduction to somebody else. So the one thing that you're right about is that offsetting and carbon reductions are one and the same thing. But when the reduction generated by one party is sold to another party to help them reach a target, that's the act of offsetting, using a reduction from somewhere else to make up a reduction you can't deliver yourself.
Why should I consider carbon offsetting?
We start off with the argument that we accepted science, which says we need an 80% reduction in greenhouse gas emissions if we're going to stabilize our climate in a way that protects our economic, social, and environmental systems. 80% is a huge ask of most businesses. And many companies can generate internal reductions of 10, 20, 30%, but then find it very difficult to get to 80%. But there are a large number of opportunities to reduce greenhouse gas emissions all around the world. And companies have that opportunity of funding those emissions, which are cheaper than the ones that they can generate within their own operations at a certain point, and therefore becoming part of the solution rather than part of the problem. And let me just say what I mean by that. If we, as individuals or as businesses, can't figure out a way to live our lives or to grow profitable, sustainable businesses without reducing our emissions by 80% by mid-century, we're part of the problem, not part of the solution.
How do I measure my carbon footprint?
It's an exercise that we do as part of what our engagement with the clients. It means that you have to gather information about how much business travel, how much energy you use, whether that's electricity, gas, or fuel, how much waste you dispose to landfill, because it tends to rot and cause methane, emit methane, which is a very potent greenhouse gas. So we measure all of those things. And each one of those activities, whether it's the use of a fossil fuel or the use of an aircraft, have emission factors. And they've been worked out by scientists and governments, which say, well, if you use a liter of petrol, you give off about half a kilogram of CO2. And so we have mechanisms or calculations that we use and methods to figure out what the carbon footprint is.
How can I reduce the carbon footprint of my business?
Generally, there are a lot of little things, and sometimes there are some very big things that every company can do. But it always starts off with you have to measure your carbon footprint because you need to know what you're emitting. And a typical footprint will probably identify emissions associated with the use of electricity, emissions associated with travel, whether that's ground travel or air travel, emissions associated with waste disposal. And once you've figured out what that is, then it becomes so much simpler to sort of say, hang on, if 30% of our emissions come from air travel, for example, what can we do to reduce air travel? Because that would reduce our footprint. And the obvious answers become travel less, use video conferencing, try and be a little more thoughtful about how staff commute to work, allowing home working or mobile working. Those are all solutions. When it comes to the use of electricity, of course, they're all the well-known things. More energy-efficient light bulbs, more energy-efficient buildings, the way we use air conditioning to heat and cool our buildings, sometimes there are huge opportunities to be more efficient.
How does going green affect my bottom line?
Let me sort of step back from that. In terms of how does it affect your competitive fitness in the marketplace, in three ways. Companies who've taken a leading position on climate change appeal to their customers sometimes more strongly, more clearly than their competitors. So it becomes a point of differentiation and it drives top line growth. Example, one of our clients, Radio Taxis Group, went carbon neutral in their London cab service and won about £1.4 million of new business associated with new clients that wanted low carbon suppliers. The other opportunity is saving costs. And clearly, every time you put a cost on carbon, you tend to drive a keener interest in our use of energy, the things that give rise to greenhouse gas emissions. And a number of our clients have reported 20 to 30% reductions in their bottom line costs of energy use simply because they've taken carbon as a lens and said, wow, we never realized we were wasting that amount of energy. And the third area is a reputational benefit that comes from companies whose commitment to action on climate change actually appeals to staff and allows their staff to feel that their personal values are more closely aligned with the corporate values and therefore feel very engaged and very positive about behavior changes that they can make to reduce emissions at work and sometimes at home.
How do I achieve carbon neutral status?
The process is a simple one, if a company is very interested in exploring that or taking the first step, which is measuring the footprint and then examining it and then purchasing carbon offsets and communicating it, that's a service that we offer. And you can simply contact us or go onto our website, which is www.carbonneutral.com. Give us a call.
www.bizzibox.com